Hello, YouTube. Hello, hello, hello. To all my beautiful people, all my prayer warriors, all my loopy warriors. I love you. I love you all. And this is my butterfly little notepad that I've had for a few years now. And I promised you guys that I would come back and speak on lupus. And first, I want to say that I'm not in the medical field. So don't take my 100% word on this. Most of the things that I wrote in the book came from my studies and some of the statistics has probably changed since I wrote in the book, but you can look those numbers up yourself because I'm sure that they've changed. I had a lupus gathering in May of last year, and so I'm quite sure some of the numbers have changed. And this is just stuff that I study and write down, and I had written it down and things like that for one of my events. Well, I've had more than one event for lupus, so, but I would read from this, and I really haven't updated the numbers of, you know, how many people is living with it right now, so we can look that up, but I'm going to still go by what I have in here. So, like I said, I'm not a doctor or anything, and also I can tell you from my experience how I get, you know, and I want to say this to the family and friends of people that has lupus. And I've seen this in living color, and I've heard several stories about it. I've been a part of it as well. When you're in so much pain, sometimes your loved ones think that you're just making it up. But I'm here to tell you, some of y'all should be ashamed of yourself, knowing this is for anybody that think that someone is playing about the lupus pain. When that flare up hit you, you think you done got hit by lightning. Your loved one is not playing unless, you know, it's just somebody that you're very close to, and you just probably feel like they're saying this to get your attention or whatever. I don't believe that someone would fake this type of pain. And right now, I'm kind of like in a flare-up. But I do go to the doctor on Friday. I had an appointment this morning. But I have fibromyalgia also, because all that comes into play with lupus and autoimmune diseases. And also, I was cut on my left side for that second surgery I told you all about to get the wound back. And that's one of the same sides that they had to cut as well for the double lung transplant. They went all the way across. And I had an open lung biopsy in 2016 that I still have a lot of nerve pain. And you all that have had surgery that that you ended up with nerve pain, it don't go away. And some parts of my body are still numb. And right now, I just feel like something is just squeezing me. And I first experienced that from the open lung biopsy. And then some months after that, I had a hiatal hernia removed, and I had my esophagus repaired. And so my body has just been cut on. And then the transplant. So I think that's why I had so many complications after my transplant. So when I left the doctor today, I just started resting and things like that. I didn't feel like doing much of nothing but resting. So I just put on my purple lip gloss today to represent my girls with my lupus. And we got some guys out there too that's got lupus. And we just keep each other in prayer because it's painful, it's aggravating, and half of the time they can't even detect where lupus came from or whatever. They really don't know. So, like I said, I'm going to tell you what information that I have. And then, I found out that I had lupus. I want to say a few years back, which means that I've been had it and I just didn't know it, because it don't come overnight. And you can't just go to a doctor in one day and they tell you have lupus. But other than now, that the pain I'm having now, my lupus has been okay, you know, except for the real damage that it done to me. So I'm going to just read some of my stuff that I wrote down once I put these glasses on, something that y'all never see me put on too much. Okay, so what is lupus? Lupus is a lifelong disorder of the immune system. The immune cells attack the body's own healthy issues. So what it's basically saying, your good cells, your immune cells attack the body's own healthy tissues, leading to inflammation, and inflammation hurts. Ooh, it swells you up. It just makes you want to, you can't hardly move. And tissue damage. Symptoms may be limited to the skin, but more often lupus also causes internal problems such as joint pain. In severe cases, it can damage the heart, the kidneys, the lungs, and other vital organs. Now, supposedly, the lupus attacked my lungs really bad. It didn't bother with my heart or my kidneys, but it definitely put the joint pain on me. In severe cases, it can damage the heart. Oh, I just said that. I'm sorry. Although there is no cure, there are treatments that can minimize the damage. In my case, I'm currently taking 2,000 milligrams of CellCept daily, along with prednisone. And I say God is able. He's able to get us through. But that pain sometimes will cause you to just, oof. My loopies know what I'm talking about. Lupus is a serious health problem that affects mainly, well, this says mainly young women, but older women have it that's probably had it all their life. So it starts when you're young, and that's why I say you just don't get it overnight. You don't even get it in a month. When they finally tell you that they detect lupus after all those tests, please believe that you've been had lupus. Missy, you okay?
Yeah.
What was that?
Shh.
I know. Come out of there. I'm sorry, guys. We heard a noise. We're trying to be careful in here. Lupus is a serious health problem that affects mainly young women. But on that, it affects women of all ages, if you ask me. But I think what they were saying is that it starts when you're young. And the disease often starts between the ages of 15 and 45, and it goes up. People of all races may get lupus. However, lupus is 3 times more common in black women than in white women. The cause of lupus, it is unknown, or what causes the immune system to become overactive. In some people, lupus becomes active after exposure to sunlight or certain medications. So, when you're in the sunlight, you got to make sure that you're wearing some sunscreen. And I know we get lazy sometimes and don't want to put it on, but we have to really be careful with not wearing our sunscreen. But right now I know it's kind of cool, but just make sure that you're covered with that, you know, and you got to get you a kind that goes with your skin. Even Aveeno have one for sensitive skin. So just whatever, you know, your pockets can afford. Well, me, I'm still, if it's hot, I use the regular sunscreen, you know. So, and certain medications, believe it or not, can make you flare up. There is 3 types of lupus. SLE, that's the most serious type of lupus that we can have. It affects many parts of the body. Brain, heart, kidney, lung, and bores. And that's the one that I was diagnosed with. And people always ask me, well, since you got your new lungs, is the lupus going to attack your lungs or anything else again? Well, you can never detect what's going to happen to you. You just have to pray that nothing does. But with the medication that I'm on now, that's what it's for, to stop that from happening again. Because by the time I got on medication for my lupus, after it had attacked my lungs, it was already too far gone anyways. So it just pretty much slowed it down. And then we have discoid, which is when you see people with skin rashes and everything like that, and the scalp bald. I have a part of that as well where my scalp had went bald, my hair in the middle or whatever. So I had kind of like a mixture. And that's why they call some of the lupus mixed connection tissue, MCTD. Most of you probably been diagnosed with that, but don't get it twisted. It's still lupus. Because you got, that means you got all different kind of lupus is going on in your body. That's what I think of it. And then you got drug-induced lupus, which some medications can cause flare-ups and pain and lupus. Yes, it can. Can you catch lupus from someone else? No, you cannot. Lupus is not catchy. You can't give it to someone else. Also, it is not a form of cancer. It is not HIV or AIDS. If a relative of a lupus patient develops any signs of lupus, he or she should see a doctor. And here are some of the signs. Red rash or color change on the face, often in the shape of a butterfly. Every now and then I see the butterfly over my nose, but not much. I don't get it much. I don't get much with my skin, but it does get dry sometimes. But I use a Aveeno lotion to help with that. I might switch over to Gold Bond. A butterfly over the bridge of the cheeks, of the nose, is a sign. Painful or swollen joints, chest pain with breathing, unusual loss of hair, that's a big one there, pale or purple fingernails or toes from cold or stress, sensitivity to the sun, and low blood count. And I get that a lot. This is a fact here. Lupus is a serious autoimmune disease affecting more than 5 million people globally. So that was the numbers that I'm talking about. So I'm sure that, well, it says more than 5 million. So that's still about right. So those are my lupus notes. And I just hope and pray that we all can be more lenient on our family members when it comes down to this, you know, to them telling you that they're in pain. And those flare-ups is nothing to play with. So if you think you have any of those symptoms, or if you're having bad symptoms, you can see your doctor. Or if you feel like you have any of those symptoms, I would go see a rheumatologist, and you get a first, second, and third opinion, because that's what you're going to need. Because some of these doctors are out for money, so we ain't looking for that right there. So just find you a good doctor and stick with them. And I just pray that we can all overcome this pain and these flare-ups, because it's nothing much we can do about it. The medicine worked when it wanted to work, you know. So I wish you all the best, and we're going to keep each other in prayer. And I love you all. I love all my loopies, males and females. So let's just keep each other in prayer and hope that God can get this pain out of our bodies. It's like inflammation, it's just so puffy. And it's just like, it feels like if you could just get a shot and suck all that pain out of you, it just feels like you just want to just, oh, please take it away. That's how it feels. So thank you all for stopping by. Oh, I know somebody gonna say this, that I didn't smile. There it is, because somebody told me last night I didn't smile, but so much was going on. So, and I'm still gonna come back with that video of the untold story. I'm still getting it together for that one. So I'll see you guys on my next video. Shaw has them lungs.